Good day, students. Today we are going to discuss about IPO or inputs process output model. All right. Our learning outcomes for today, students will be able to understand what are the different inputs of resources or synonyms of inputs, how inputs are processed, and they are going to synthesize the application of this conceptual framework of inputs, processed outputs. To start with, the input-output model is a functional graph that identifies the input, output, and process that is required to transform these inputs into outputs. Outputs could be defined as goods. It could be product or it could be service. The model is sometimes configured to include any storage that might happen in the process as well. The inputs represent the flow of data and materials into the process from the outside. The processing step includes all the activities required to effect a transformation or processing of the inputs. The outputs are the data and product flowing out from the transformation process. And of course, you have a feedback loop. Right? Okay. And of course, this IPO model has many applications. It could be applied in business organizations, whether you are product-based or service-based. It could be also applied in human relations or employees, and it could also be applied in applications, computer applications, and software. All right. Here is a typical conceptual framework of the IPO. You have inputs, production process, outputs, the outcomes, and the effectiveness. Okay. All right. Let us try to explain this in layman's term. So again, your inputs are your resources needed, okay, such as your raw materials, your machineries, so that you can process that into production, those inputs of resources, and transform that and convert that to outputs. Okay. Now, there is an additional variable here of the outcome, no? The result. Okay. So, on this section, it could be the outcome, which is the actual result versus your inputs, or it could be the target. No? So, effectiveness is defined as outcomes over the inputs, while productivity can be shown from these three variables of how effective or how productive you process your inputs to output. And productivity, as we all know, is outputs over inputs. Okay? So, the skills a worker has as a result of education, training, or experience that can be used in production are called human capital, because among all the important attributes of inputs, the most important is men or labor, okay? Because of this human capital. Example, students who are attending college or university education are acquiring human capital workers who are gaining skills through experience or through training are acquiring human capital. Children who are learning to read are acquiring human capital. Therefore, the amount of labor available to an economy can be increased in two ways. One is to increase the total quantity of labor, either by increasing the number of people available to work or by increasing the average number of hours of work per week. The other is to increase the amount of human capital possessed by workers. So this is self-development and training. Firms can, however, use money to acquire capital. Money is a form of financial capital. Financial capital includes money and other paper assets such as stocks and bonds that represent claims on future payments. These financial assets are not capital, but they can be used directly or indirectly to purchase factors of production or goods and services. An example of the factors of production used to produce a shift. The land. For example, a shirt factory or t-shirt factory. An example for the factors of production or means of production. Let's say the land that the t-shirt factory sits on, the electricity used to run the plant and machinery's equipment, the raw cotton from which the shirts are made, the employees, the laborers who make the shirts, the factory and equipment used in the manufacturing process, as well as the money needed to operate the factory. And of course, one of the means of production is also not only land, labor, and capital, but also the entrepreneurship, that its skill used to coordinate the other resources to initiate the production process. So one of the means of production or factors of production is entrepreneurship or the entrepreneur. Let's proceed. So these are examples of the 5 M's or one of the inputs of materials or one of the factors of inputs. We have the 5 M's: men, machines, materials, money, and methods. Or we have the factors of production and or the means of production. This is land, labor, capital, and the entrepreneur. So all of these are examples of inputs that has to be processed. Okay, let us proceed. Moving forward on this slide, we are going to discuss the different inputs. Like for example, let us discuss men. We know for a fact that the human capital or men or employee or labor is the most important asset or input of resource. Why? Because men is the human capital, meaning to say our employees has to be motivated in order to perform at their highest peak. Now, the question is, how are we going to motivate our employees? There are many programs and methodologies of satisfying the needs of our employees, like for example, offering them a fair salary and wages, providing them occupational safety and health, providing them the regulatory government compliances, giving them incentives, okay, rewards, performance evaluation. So basically, in the business organization, the point of contact for our motivation of our employees is the human resource department. Because the human resource department is the window to our employees. They, they have different functional responsibilities, like for example, salaries and wages, benefits, occupational safety and health, compliances, training and development, recruitment, training and development. So as far as in recruitment, so there are examples of inputs, like for example, they have different qualifications. So that's part of the inputs of the human resource department when recruiting talents. Degrees that you should have, your experience, your length of experience, those are parts of the input, and they are going to process that through a series of interviews, written examinations, final interviews, situational analysis, in order to acquire the appropriate and talent that they need inside their business organization. So men is very important. It has to be motivated, no? There are many ways and means. Some in BPO companies, in call center, they encourage and motivate their employees to be productive by giving them incentives, awards, no? Allowing them to be trained, no? And nowadays, during the pandemic, there is already a work from home, wherein it creates a work-life balance to the employees. The next is materials. In materials, there are many ways on how to process materials. Okay, and one of these is, for example, using just-in-time inventory, Kanban methods. First in, first out. So there are many inventory management tools that can be used. Like for example, in acquiring volume acquisition of materials, you create a purchasing power to get and negotiate for a discount in terms of payment. And for materials, it is process through our machineries and equipment. Like for example, with when it comes to machineries and equipment, if there is an intervention of technology, there is productivity. And productivity is defined as more output, less input. Okay? That is productivity. How? Like for example, if companies will acquire and replace a semi-automatic machine to a fully automatic machine, there is cost, but the long-term benefit of it is savings in terms of employees, because before, in semi-automatic process, you can, there are, for example, 4 workers involved in semi-automatic process, but when you converted it to fully automatic, there is 1 or 2 employees that will operate and the setup, the adjustment and parameters of the fully automatic machine. So that is productivity and cost savings for that matter. And because of technology, right now there is already artificial intelligence, Internet of Things. So this makes the life of workers and entrepreneurs to be comfortable, in the sense that information is just a click of a finger, and the processing of that information helps us in our sound business decision making. All right. So that is machineries, and also methods. In methods, there are many ways, no? Like for example, if you are in quality control, there is what you call the different statistical tools. And one of the most popular quality control management that is being applied is the Six Sigma, no? Is the Six Sigma. Okay? So this really improves zero rejection or zero rate. of rejection. It improves quality almost 99.999%. Okay? When we use Six Sigma in our process in quality control. In inventory, we have just-in-time inventory, Kanban method, okay? The FIFO method, first in, first out. There are a lot of things. And if you use statistical quality control charts and tools, no, we can predict the rejection, the cause, the root cause analysis of rejection. And of course, the last is money, which is very important to produce resources, to buy resources. So that is a very simple explanation of the IPO model, inputs, process or transformation, and output. And what is very important is the feedback loop for continuous development and continuous improvement. That ends up our tutorial video for today. Thank you for your continuous patronage. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing this tutorial video. I'll see you next time. Always keep safe. Thank you.